Welcome everyone, I'm Mohit Mittal, back again for you with a new video for English Language and Literature for Grade 9. Today, we'll be discussing about a poem, The Road Not Taken by Robert Frost. Without wasting much of the time, let me switch over to the poem directly. What theme or what message it gives? Let me just give it the explanation in crux form. This poem, The Road Not Taken, just simplifies that we should take the decision in our life so prudently that may not affect us later on. Any decision taken in life gives us a long effect. In this poem, the basic poetic device used are repetition. Repetition is all about repeating the lines one after the other. The second is about metaphor. Metaphor is all about comparison. Comparison, what is the difference between simile and metaphor? In simile, we compare one or the other thing using like or as. But in metaphor, we never use like or as. We just compare the thing. For an example, in simile, I say that he fought like a lion in the battle. Here, like I have used, so it is simile. And if I wanted to convert the same sentence in metaphor, he was the lion in the battle. So here also I've compared, but it is a metaphor because I did not use like or as. Now if I talk about the other poetic device is personification. Personification is all about dealing with the things, etc., or making animal or any place an ideal thing and relating it with human attribute. That is all about personification. I'll discuss more where personification is used in the poem when we shall switch on to the poem. Fine. So let us begin with the poem. So two roads diverged in a yellow wood. See, the poet was in such a point where he could see two roads and they were diverging. So we can deal the same with our life. We have sometime one or the other choices and we need to get one choice or we need to opt only one choice. So poet was in a dilemma, which one to choose and which one to not, because he knew that and we even know that it has a long lasting effect. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood. Yellow wood means the forest area. Diverged means separated, means there were two roads which were diverging and they were giving the different path. And sorry, I could not travel both. The poet wanted to say that it was impossible to travel both the road, being poet the one. And we have to choose one. We cannot go for other choice even. And be one traveler, long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Means the poet says that he stood there for a while and he thought for a long, but he could not have a firm decision. And looked down and he tried to bend and he looked far possible way. Means he was bending down and he was seeing up to where the road end, so that he could judge it out which road would be better for him or not to choose in the life even. And looked far down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Means he wanted to see the bushes, areas, etc. Means up to where the road ends. According to the first stanza, we could consider that the poet tried his level best. He bent down even. He could see that the road was ending to a undergrowth. Undergrowth means there were some bushes, etc. So as an individual, we may have many choices in our life, but we cannot opt each and every choice. We need to opt only one. Now let us go to the second stanza. Then took the other. Took the other means the second road. Means poet thought of a better claim on the second road. Just as fair and having perhaps the better claim. See, somewhere he thought of taking the second road, means opting the second road, because he felt like there would be a good option or a better claim going on this road, because it was grassy and wanted wear. See, grassy and wanted wear, it means less traveled. Because why he took the less traveled road? Because he wanted to do something different in life. He was really a good man and he wanted to accept some experiences or opportunities in the life. Because it was grassy and wanted wear. Wanted wear, see, wanted wear means less traveled, and wanted wear, W and W, they both are alliteration. When the repetition of the same sound, W, is repeated, it is all about alliteration. Though, as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. See what he says, that he promises himself, I may opt the second road. But somewhere he was in a dilemma. He thinks that even this road seems like that it is also covered, or it is also traveled by these many people only. Means somewhere he was confused which road to travel and which road not to travel. See, had warned them really about the same. See, really about the same means both road looked equally. Means somewhere they were equally warned. Equally warned means equally traveled. So up to stanza 1 and 2, if I talk about the CBSE examination or the class examination, internal examination, basically what the question can be asked is, what does the road signify? It's very easy. The road signify the way of our life, how we are living and how we are choosing an option to lead our life. Okay, one more question what I felt like can come is, which road was chosen by the poet? The poet chose the second road, or the other way. That is all. And it can even be asked, why did he choose the second road? Because he wanted to do something new in his life. Let's switch on to the next paragraph. And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. See, and both that morning equally lay. And early in the morning, when the poet felt like seeing the road, the both the road were all equal. Means the leaves, the quantity of the leaves were all the same on road one and the other road. In leaves, no step had trodden black. And moreover, it seems like that there were many leaves, and the road means even a single road is not traveled by any passenger or any person. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Means the poet says that I may choose one road here and I may keep the other road for the other day. Somewhere the poet wanted to choose both the road. Means he wanted to have an experience traveling the first road and the second road. Yet knowing how ways leads onto the way. Even he never knew about where the road may end. But somewhere in his mind, he wanted to travel both. It happens with we human being also. Whenever we get a choice to opt one, somewhere comes in our mind is to opt both. But we are all bounded the same way the poet was. I doubted if I should ever come back. See, the poet, he kept first road for the another day. He thought that when I'll turn back, when I'll come back again, I'll travel this road. But I doubted, means somewhere he doubted, if I should ever come back, means whether he would be returning back again or not, and whether he had a dilemma that he would be able to travel the road which he did not. Means suppose, so if he is choosing the second road, will he be able to come back, and so he could be able to choose the first road or not. Somewhere it was a great dilemma in his life. See, in the beginning of the poem itself, I told you about personification, where it will be used, I'll be discussing. So it clicked my mind that in one of the line I read in second stanza, it was grassy and wanted wear. See here, Robert Frost, what he has used, it was grassy. He has used road as if it was very grassy and wanted wear. Means as if the road is human and it wants to wear and tear. That is all about personification used. Okay, let's come to the last paragraph or the last stanza of the poem. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Which the poet, he says that he'll be in a sigh. Sigh is all about a deep breath, etc. Means he would be telling to others whether he would be able to travel both the road or not. Or what is his experience traveling a road? And what is his experience? What is he feeling while he's not able to travel the other road? Somewhere ages and ages hence. Means somewhere ages means after many years and years he would be telling to others. Means he wanted to share experience. Somewhere the opportunities of the life is all about the comment given by the poet here. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one less traveled by. And see, the poet, what does he say is that he traveled, or he opted for the road which was less traveled by. And I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. With somewhere he will be telling to other people ages and ages that I chose the road which was very less traveled and that has made challenges in my life. Means somewhere he is very happy that he chose the second road which was less traveled. Means he is a person who can easily accept the challenges and he is very happy for the same. And that has made all means somewhere poet want us to even opt for the second choice where we do not have much of the choices thereafter and which is very challenging. Means somewhere the poet says that we should not go for an easy way. Somewhere we need to accept the adventures and challenges of the life. So dear students and dear friends, the basic message what we get from this poem is about the acceptance of the choices in life. We should not make a haste decision. We should be very prudent before accepting any challenges. And moreover, the divergence of the road, as mentioned in the poem itself, signifies the offers which we get in our life. We should not opt easy path in a very haste manner. We should think twice or thrice before choosing a path. So we should not go for the end result. We should not overthink about the end result. Rather, we should be ready to accept the challenges, etc., or the new opportunities which life can give us. And moreover, the divergence of the road that provided us the same thing, that two options which we get in our life and we need to choose only one. See, dear children and friends, there is a simple question that confuses us a lot. Means the question was, does the speaker seems very happy about the choice taken? There may be two answers, but I go with the answer that the poet or the speaker wasn't happy. How? Because there was a line which I read it that he would be telling this with a sigh. Sigh is till the last breath or till the last breath, etc., or till the last moment of his life. And he would be a bit sad that he did not choose the other road. He did not choose the easy road. And moreover, he could have opted and he could have brought easiness in his life, but he did not. The complete crux of the poem gives us a message that we should be very wise before opting a decision. It's all about how we choose a decision in our life and we should be very prudent and we should be like an adventurous person ready to accept the challenges in life so that we can go ahead and make our life very easy. I hope, my dear friends and dear children, the complete explanation of the poem is clear to you. I made it very easy for your understanding. Hope you liked it. Please like it, share it, and subscribe it. Thank you from Mohit. Goodbye. Take care. Have a nice day.